First and foremost, I give thanks to God for assembling our brothers and sisters on this blessed day to worship Him.
感谢主在这个赐福的一天，使主耶稣带领我们每一位弟兄姐妹都来敬拜他。
We thank God that our brothers and sisters here look highly upon this fourth commandment of God.
感谢主在这里的每一位弟兄姐妹都非常看重神的第四个诫命。
If you look at this commandment, you realize that this is like a weekly test that God has given to us.
如果我们看这个诫命的话呢，我们就会觉得这像是每周主耶稣神给我们的这个测验一样。
Just like in the book of Exodus, chapter 16.
就像出埃及记十六章所提到的。
God has sent a manna down from heaven to feed His chosen people.
神从天上降下玛纳，喂养他的选民。
But on the seventh day, they are not supposed to go out to pick manna for themselves.
但是在第七天，他们不可以出去去捡玛纳吃。
We realize that what they have gathered on the sixth day is sufficient for them to last till the seventh day.
我们会发现，他们第六天所取的那些玛纳，其实是足够他们第七天所吃的。
So in a way, it's like a test from God.
所以这就像是神给他们的一个测验一样。
We find that this test is essential for the building up of our faith.
我们会发现这个测验对我们建立信仰是非常的重要。
Sometimes we have to be put to the test in order to know how faithful we are towards God.
有的时候我们也应该要被受到这个试验，才能知道我们对神是否有忠心，多么的忠心。
So if we are able to observe the fourth commandment in the way that the Bible teaches us to observe,
所以我们还是可以按照圣经所教导我们的方式来守安息圣日。
Find that in the process our faith will be built up.
所以我们会发现，在这过程当中呢，我们的信仰就会被建立起来。
We'll begin to appreciate the kindness that God has shown to us.
我们就会开始感激神对我们所显的这些良善。
Because He is faithful and He is good to us.
因为神是信实的，他对我们都是非常的良善。
So Sabbath day, you know, is something that not only we observe, we also need to find rest.
安息日不单单是我们要来守的，并且也是我们也要在这一天得到安息。
If we can put our trust in God,
如果我们可以把我们的如果我们可以投靠神的话
，observe the Sabbath day the way that the Bible teaches,
可以守着圣经上面所教导的安息圣日
，then truly on the Sabbath we can gain entry into the rest of the Lord.
那么我们在可以安息圣日的话呢，就可以真正的进入到神的安息里面。
Sometimes we are not able to rest on the Sabbath day.
有的时候我们在安息日没有办法得到安息。
We feel very unsettled in the heart.
我们觉得内心是没有办法平定下来。
Because we are not able to fully trust in Him.
因为我们没有办法完完全全来信靠神。
So we hope that our Lord Jesus, our merciful God, will give us more strength to keep His holy Sabbath.
所以希望我们的主耶稣慈悲的父可以在这安息圣日给我们更多的力量。
Today I'm going to talk about the story of Job.
今天我将要与大家一起分享的是约伯的故事。
Apart from the book of Job, yeah, other part of the scriptures do not mention much about Job, this character.
除了约伯记这一章这一本书以外，其他的圣经章节没有提到约伯这个人。
You find that you know Job has gone through a lot in his life.
我们知道约伯的一生经历了很多事情。
Although God said that he was a blameless and righteous man,
虽然神说他是一个完全正直的人
，one who feared God and shunned evil,
是敬畏神、远离恶事的人。
His life was full of troubles and toils.
但是他的一生都是充满了这些愁苦和烦恼。
So the question is, how are we going to learn from the story of Job?
那问题是，我们要如何从约伯的故事中学习到一些内容呢
？I want you to read Ezekiel.
我们请看以西结书。
Please turn to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 14.
以西结书十四章。
Ezekiel chapter 14.
以西结书十四章。
We read verse 14 and verse 20.
十四节和二十节。
Ezekiel chapter 14, verse 14 and verse 20.
以西结书十四章十四节二十节。
Even these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, were in it. They would deliver only themselves by their righteousness, says the Lord God.
其中虽有挪亚、但以理、约伯这三人，他们只仍因他们的义救自己的性命，这是主说的。
Verse 20.
二十节。
Even though Noah, Daniel, and Job were in it, as I live, says the Lord God, they would deliver neither son nor daughter; they would deliver only themselves by their righteousness.
虽有挪亚、但以理、约伯在其中，主神说：“我指着我的永生起誓，他们连儿女都不能救，只能因他们的义救自己的性命。”
So from the passage here, we are told that Noah.This Daniel and Job, you know, were righteous people because they knew how to intercede for others.
我们从这几两节中看出挪亚、但以理和约伯，他们是个义人，因为他们懂得如何来为他人来代求。
So one of the aspects that we can look at when studying the story of Job is the righteousness of Job.
我们来学习约伯记这一章的话，其中一方面我们可以来学习约伯的义。
To see how he actually maintained his righteousness before God.
来看看他是如何在神的面前保持着自己的义。
He has gone through a lot of trials and tribulation.
他也经历了许多的这种患难和试炼。
He remains steadfast in the Lord without wavering in his faith.
但是在他还是让自己保守自己坚固在神的里面，并且没有动摇。
The second passage I want you to read is in James chapter 5.
我们可以请看第二节是在雅各记第五章。雅各书第五章。
We turn to James chapter 5.
雅各书第五章。
We read from verse 10 to verse 11.
我们读第十节到十一节。
James chapter 5, verse 10 and verse 11.
雅各书五章第十节到十一节。
Verse 10, my brethren, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord as an example of suffering and patience.
弟兄们，你们要把那先前奉主名说话的众先知当作人受苦、人忍耐的榜样。
James teaches the believers to emulate the good example of the ancient prophets.
这里雅各长老教导我们，就是要来学习先前就是会受苦、受忍耐的那些众先知。
To learn from the example of suffering and patience in their work for the Lord.
就是在他们为主受苦还有忍耐的这个榜样，我们要学习。
So you find that you know the Old Testament scriptures, especially the prophet, teach us how to suffer.And how to be patient in times of suffering.
我们知道，在旧约，很多先知都教导我们在患难的时候，我们要如何的来忍耐，并且来受苦。
Now verse 11 it mentioned about Job.
第十一节这里提到约伯。
Verse 11.
十一节。
Indeed, we count them blessed who endure. You have heard of the perseverance of Job, and seen the end intended by the Lord, that the Lord is very compassionate and merciful.
那先前忍耐的人，我们称他们是有福的。你们听见过约伯的忍耐，也知道主给他的结局。明显主是满心怜悯，大有慈悲。
At least there are two key points that we can learn from.
至少这里有两个关键点我们可以学习到。
One is about the perseverance of Job.
一个是约伯的忍耐。
Second is about the compassion and mercy of God towards Job.
第二个是主 是对约伯如何的满心怜悯和大有慈悲。
Some of us may be wondering.
很多人就会开始很好奇。
When we look at the story in the book of Job.
当我们看约伯记的故事的时候。
Especially in the first two chapters, we find that God practically you know, took everything away from Job.
特别是在第一两章的时候，我们可以看到神是如何亲自把约伯的一切的东西都拿走。
And you find that God actually allowed, you know, disasters in quick successions, one after another, to come upon Job.
我们也看到神是如何让灾难一个一个的降临在约伯的身上。
So within a short period of time, he lost everything.
在很短暂的期间，约伯失去了一切。
How can we see the compassion and the mercy of the Lord?
那我们如何在这里可以看到神的大有怜悯和满怀慈爱呢？
But according to the book of James.
但是按照雅各书里面所提到的
This is the lessons that we need to learn.
这个是我们今天应该要来学习的这个课
Even in great trials,
即使是在很大的试炼当中
For anyone who truly trusts in the Lord,
对一个完完全全来相信神的人来说
He should be able to see the compassion and the mercy of God.
他是可以看得见神的满心怜悯和大有慈悲
Today in our Christian life,
今天在我们基督徒的生活里
The Bible says that, you know, our life is never easy.
圣经提到我们的生活不会是一帆风顺的。
But the question is, can we see the compassion and the mercy of God?
但是问题是我们是否可以在生活中看到神的怜悯和慈悲呢？
For us who can see God's mercy,
对我们来说要来看见神的这个怜悯。
In times of pain and suffering,
在这种患难和痛苦的时候，
we find that our understanding will assuage our pain.
我们会发现我们的这种了解会减少我们的这种痛苦。
Because we know that God is in control of all things.
因为我们都深知神是掌管一切的人。
Sometimes we suffer, you know, by ourselves.
有的时候我们是因为自己而受到这个受苦。
We feel that no one can understand us.
我们认为没有人可以了解我们。
In time of difficulties, we feel that the whole world is against us.
在困难的时候呢，我们就是认为整个世界好像都在敌对我们一样。
I think the simple reason is that because we are not able to see the compassion and mercy of God.
这个简单的原因是因为我们没有办法看到神的大有怜悯和慈悲。
So to be able to see God's mercy and experience His compassion is essential in our Christian life.
那要来看见神的满心怜悯和大有慈悲，对我们基督徒来说是非常的重要。
I want you to read First Corinthians.
我们请看哥林多前书。
Please turn to the book of First Corinthians, chapter 2.
请看哥林多前书第二章。
Verse 12.
哥林多前书二章十二节。
First Corinthians chapter 2 verse 12.
哥林多前书第二章十二节。
Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God.
我们所领受的并不是世上的灵，乃是从神来的灵，叫我们人知道神开恩赐给我们的事。
Sometimes if we want to see the grace that He has given to us,
有的时候如果我们想要看到神所赐给我们的恩典的话，
or we said to have this experience of knowing that He has given grace to us,
或者是想要体验到神给我们这个恩典的这个体验，
we need the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
那么我们都需要圣灵的带领。
So when our life is directed by the Spirit,
所以如果我们的生活是被圣灵所带领的话，
or we live a life that is filled by the Spirit,
或者是过着一个被圣灵所充满的生活。
Surely we can see the grace that He has given to us, even in times of trouble.
那么在我们即使在我们困难的时候呢，我们还是可以看到神的恩典。
Because we are His children, obviously our Father, our Heavenly Father, is merciful towards us.
因为我们是神的儿女，所以我们的天父肯定是对我们都是充满慈悲。
So this is the lesson that James wants us to learn from the story of Job.
所以这是雅各长老想要我们从约伯身上所学习到的课。
Now I want you to turn to the book of Job. We turn to Job chapter 1.
我们请看回约伯记第一章。
We turn to Job chapter 1.
约伯记第一章。
Chapter 1 talks about, you know, some exchanges which has taken place in heaven between God and Satan.
这里提到就是在天上就是撒旦跟神的对话。
Like finally, you know, God agreed, the challenge of Satan to go against Job.
就是最终神就是同意让撒旦来进行对约伯的这个事挑战。
But one thing we need to understand, actually, God is in control.
但是我们要了解到的一件事情就是神是掌控一切的事情。
So we find that, you know, the power of God is infinitely greater than that of Satan.
我们可以看到神的大能呢是远远的大于撒旦的大能。
I want you to read chapter 1.
我们可以看第一章。
Verse 12.
十二节。
Chapter 1, verse 12.
第一章十二节。
And the Lord said to Satan, Behold, all that he has is in your power, only do not lay a hand on his person. So Satan went out from the presence of the Lord.
神对撒旦说，凡他所有的都在你手中，只是不可伸手加害于他。
So here we find that God actually set a limit for Satan.
所以我们这里看到神对撒旦设下了一个限制。
Basically to tell him how much harm he can inflict upon Job.
其实就是告诉撒旦，就是说他对约伯所做的这个挑战最多可以做到哪个极点。
So he was under,he is under the control.Of God.
所以撒旦也是服服于神的掌管之下。
Now here we find that Satan went away from the presence of God.
所以这里我们看到撒旦从神面前退去。
From verse 13 onward, we begin to see the sufferings of Job.
从十三节开始，我们就可以看到约伯的受难。
Now I want you to read verse 13.
我们请看十三节。
Now there was a day when his sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine in their oldest brother's house. And the messengers came to Job and said the oxen were plowing and the donkey feeding beside them. When the Sabaeans raided them and took them away, indeed they have killed the servants with the edge of the sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you. Verse 16, while he was still speaking, another also came and said, the fire of God fell from heaven and burned up the sheep and the servants and consumed them, and I alone have escaped to tell you. Now verse 17, while he was still speaking, another also came and said, the Chaldeans formed three bands, raided the camels and took them away, yes, killed the servants with the edge of the sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you. Now here it talks about, you know, on a day, you know, this Satan came and took away everything that Job owned.
这里提到就是在一天，在有一天，撒旦来了，就把约伯的所有的东西都夺去。
All his fortune was taken away.
就是约伯的这些所有的一切财产全都
被拿走。Now this part of the scripture.Killing of the servants.
这里也提到就是仆人被杀。
It's like, you know, different group of servants were slaughtered.
就像是不同小组的这个仆人都被击杀。
So when we studied Genesis,
所以当我们来查考就是创世纪的时候
，you find that Abraham also came from the same place.
我们知道亚伯拉罕也是也都是有同样的这种事情发生。
Came from the same place.
也是来自同一个地方。
Job here in verse 1 say, the Bible says he was a man in the land of Uz.
这里就是想到他是
乌斯，
都是来自乌斯的地方。
And Job and this Abraham also came from that place.
所以亚伯拉罕他也是来自乌斯。
You find that their servants represents their strength.
所以我们可以看到他们的仆人就代表他们的力量。
When Lot was captured,
就是当罗德被捕的时候。
You find that Abraham selected, you know, the servant from his own household to go and rescue Lot.
我们会发现当时亚伯拉罕就是从他家中的仆人中选出一些人来去拯救罗德。
One of the things that Satan, did to Job is to take away the protections.
所以撒旦所做的其中的一件事情呢，就是把约伯的这些保护全都夺走。
It's like his military might.
就像是约伯的这个军事这些军中的力量一样被夺走。
To take all of them away from Job.
就是完完全全的从约伯手中都夺走。
So that he could rely on no one.
这样子的话，导致约伯没有办法依靠任何人。
Satan also killed all the animals.That belongs to Job.
撒旦并且也把属于约伯的这些牲畜全都击杀。
And also in the same chapter, we find that all his children also died on the same day.
在同一章节，我们可以看到他的约伯的儿女在同一天也都死了。
So you know, it's like you know, these disasters happen to Job very quickly, one after another.
我们会发现这个发生在约伯身上的灾难是来得很急很突然，就是一件接着一件。
When we enter into the second chapter,
当我们看到第二章的时候
，again, yeah, this Satan incited God to take up the challenge.
所以撒旦。
We read chapter 3.
我们请看第三章。
The last part it says, although you incited me against him to destroy him without cause.
最后一节。
最后一段。第三节。
第二章第三节。Okay. 第三。第二章第三节，你虽然激动我攻击他，无辜的毁灭他，他仍然持守他的纯正。
So on this occasion, you find that you know, Job was inflicted with boils all over his body.
我们这里可以看到，就是约伯身上都长满了这些毒疮。
We say he lost his health.
我们知道约伯失去了他的健康。
And he also lost his love, the love from his wife.
他并且也失去了对他妻子对他的爱。
Because the wife said to him,
因为他的妻子对他说
Do you still hold fast to your integrity? Curse God and die.
你仍然持守你的纯正吗？你弃掉神死了吧。
So it's like he lost everything.
就像是约伯已经失去了一切。
Now we need to understand that he was one of the most prominent figures in the East at the time.
我们要记得，就是约伯当时是在东方里面，他也算是一个非常突出有名的人。
We can see this in chapter 1 verse 3.
因为我们可以在第一章第三节可以看到。
Even this was taken away from him.
但是这些很多全都从他那边都拿走了。
Now I want you to read chapter 19.
我们看十九章。
We read chapter 19.
我们看十九章。
This is what Job has said about himself.
这个就是约伯对自己所说的。
We read verse 13.
十三节。十三节。
He has removed my brothers far from me, and my acquaintances are completely estranged from me. My relatives have fell, and my close friends have forgotten me. Those who dwell in my house and my maid servants count me as a stranger. I am an alien in their sight.
他把我的兄弟隔在远处，使我所认识的全然与我生疏，我的亲戚与我断绝，我的密友都忘记我，在我家寄居的和我的使女都以我为外人，我在他们眼中看为外邦人。
So this is how Job was treated when he became ill.
这个就是当约伯失去健康的时候，他是受到如何的对待。
Because even his friend could not recognize him.
因为甚至连他的朋友都没办法认出他。
So emotionally he was in suffering.
所以在他的情感上，他也就是很痛苦。
We said mentally he also suffered.
那在他的那种理智上面，他也受很多苦。
We read chapter 17.
我们可以看十七章。
Job chapter 17.
约伯记十七章。
And again, he prayed to God for relief.
这再一次约伯祈求神可以使他解脱。第六节。
But he has made me a byword of the people, and I have become one in whose face men spit.
神使我做了民中的笑谈，他们也吐唾沫在我脸上。
You find that, from the most prominent person at that time, now he became what? Like worse than a beggar.
我们可以看到约伯是从一个非常有出名的一个人，现在变了一个比乞丐还不如。
So he suffered a lot.
所以他受了很多的苦。
This kind of suffering is unbearable to most of us.
这种的受苦对我们很多人来说肯定是承受不住的。
Now, so when you look at the integrity of Job,
但是我们可以看到约伯的这个纯正的心。
We turn back to chapter 1.
我们再看回第一章。
We say when the first wave of attack came upon him.
我们知道当第一个攻到面临他的时候
，We find that he was able to absorb them, if you like.
我们会发现约伯是有办法来接受这个问题。
We need to understand that trial and tribulation will come our way.
我们知道，就是在我们的人生当中，试炼和试验都会来临。
So in times of peace, we must get ourselves prepared.
所以在我们安稳日子的时候呢，我们一定要预备好自己。
So that we have this faith which is strong enough, to accept.Whatever thing we may suffer.
所以使我们可以有这样的信心，不管遇到什么问题，我们都可以来接受这种试验。
I want you to read chapter 1, verse 20.
我们再看第一章二十节。
Chapter 1, verse 20.
第一章二十节。
Then Job arose, tore his robe, and shaved his head, and he fell to the ground and worshipped.
约伯便起来，撕裂外袍，剃了头，伏在地上下拜。
Now, the word worship tells us about the mindset of Job at the time.
这个敬拜就是代表说当时约伯的这个心态是如何。
He continued to believe in God.
他还是继续相信神。
So he must have built his faith well in times of peace.
所以我们可以看到就是在约伯安稳的日子的时候呢，他的信心是已经被建立起来。
Sometimes in times of suffering, we may lose our faith.
有的时候在我们遇到受难的时候呢，我们可能会失去信心。
We may not even want to worship God anymore.
我们甚至连敬拜神的心都没有了。
We may tell ourselves to stop coming to the church.
我们有可能会告诉自己说不要再来教会了。
Because in our mind we feel that God is not fair.
因为在我们的心态里面我们会认为说神是不公平。
We say, being a child of God, how could God allow such a thing to happen to me?
我们会说我们身为神的儿女，为什么神会使这些事情发生在我们的身上呢？
So when you look at verse 20,
所以我们看二十节。
The first thing that he did when he heard what has happened to his children,
就是当约伯听到他孩子所发生的事情，他所做的第一件事情是
he fell to the ground and worshipped.
他是伏在地上下拜。
Now I want you to look at verse 21.
我们再看二十一节。
This is his understanding of God.
这个就是神的这种对神的了解。
Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
我赐生出于母胎，也必赐生归回。赏赐的是神，收取的也是神。神的名是应当称颂的。
We say that his understanding is genuine.
我们会发现约伯的对神的了解是很正直。
Because when he was put to the test, he was able to utter such words.
因为当他在遇到这些试验的时候呢，他还是有办法说出这些话。
So verse 21 represents his state of mind at the time.
所以21节就是代表了就是约伯当时的这种心态。
And he knew that God has the sovereign right to give and to take away.
他知道神有这种大的权人 来赏赐，也有权人来收走。
And so this is something that we need to work on in terms of our faith.
这个是在我们信仰上是我们应该要好好下功夫的地方。
We must understand that God has the power to give.And he also has the power to take away from us.
我们一定要了解神有这个权人来赏赐给我们，并且也有权人把这些东西收回。
Verse 22. 22节.
In all this, Job did not sin
nor charge God with wrong.
在这一切的事上，约伯并不犯罪，也不以神为遗忘。
So he continued to uphold his own integrity before the Lord.
所以约伯还是仍然持守他对神的纯正。
Now, you know, after the second wave of attack from Satan,
那当他就是经历了第二波被撒旦的攻击的时候，
I want you to read verse 10, chapter 2, verse 10.
我们可以看第二章第十节。
But he said to the wife, you speak as one of the foolish women speaks. Shall we indeed accept good from God? And shall we not accept adversity? In all this, Job did not sin with His lips.
约伯却对他说：“你说话像愚妄的妇人一样。难道我们从神手里得福，不也受祸吗？在这一切的事上，约伯并不以口犯罪。”
Again, here we can see his understanding of the Lord and his great faith in God.
这里我们可以看到约伯对神的了解，并且对神的信心。
Sometimes we find that for us to overcome, you know, adversities in life.
有的时候我们会就是觉得在要我们来战胜和克服生活上的这些困难的时候
Yes, we may require encouragement from our brothers and sisters.
我们是的，我们可能会需要弟兄姐妹们的这种勉励
In order to stand firm in the Lord.
要使我们可以在主里可以站立的稳
What is even more important is that we must have this knowledge of God.
但是最重要的是我们一定要对神有这种的认识
And this knowledge of God must become the principle of our life.
对神的这种认识一定要成为我们生活中的原则。
By that it means whatever we do, we base it on the principle that we have received from God.
这个意思就是说，不管我们在生活当中我们所做的这些原则，都是按照神的出于神的旨意。
So in this way, we will not sin against God in times of adversity or in times of troubles.
只有这样子的话，我们遇到困难的时候呢，我们就不会犯罪来得罪神。
So we find that when we enter into like chapter 3.
所以当我们看到第三章的时候
It's like, you know, like the faith of Job has gone down.
我们会看到约伯的信心就开始慢慢的在下滑。
Because he began to curse his own birth.
因为他开始在咒诅自己的出生。
He wished that he was still born.
他就是希望自己就像刚出生的人一样。他没有出生。他希望就是自己好像是还没有出生就直接死了一样。
叫什么夭折。
夭折。
And the other thing is, you know, he said to God that, you know, after he has met with all this tribulation, he shouldn't be given life.
就是当他遇到这么多遭遇患难的时候呢，他就不应该就是被生到这个世上。
Because, you know, when you read all the example we have given,
因为当我们读到这些例子的时候，
His grief was very great.
我们可以看到他的痛苦是很大的。
So when his friend came,
所以当他的朋友来的时候
They sat down with him 7 days without talking to him.
他们 坐下约伯旁边7天都没有跟约伯讲话。
All of them were grieved.
因为他们每一个人都是很伤心。
They could not even recognize Job.
因为他们没有办法认出约伯来。
So you find that, you know, it's like Job allowed his grief to take the better of him.
就是我们发现就是约伯让他的这种痛苦来超过他，战胜他。
From chapter 4 onward, you can see a cycle of discourses or debate between Job and his friend.
我们可以看从第四章可以看到，第四章之后呢，就可以看到约伯与他朋友之间的这种争议和对话。
So Job was trying to defend himself and to trying to justify his actions.
就是约伯为自己辩护，并且要来为自己的行为来辩护。
So finally, God spoke to him.
最终神对 对约伯讲话。
So he came to realizations.
所以约伯就有这种醒察和意识到。
He has made mistakes against God.
他做了错事，来得罪神。
I want you to turn to Job chapter 40.
我们请看约伯记第四十章。
Job chapter 40.
约伯记第四十章。
I want you to read verse 3.
第三节。
This is what Job said to the Lord.
这是约伯对神所说的话。
We read verse 4.
我们请看第四节。
Verse 4.
第四节。
Behold, I am vile. What shall I answer you? I lay my hand over my mouth.
我是卑贱的，我用什么回答你呢？只好用手捂口。
You find that the word vile is a very strong, like a negative word.
我们知道卑贱就好像是个非常负面的话，单词。
And he used it on himself.
他把这个词用在自己身上。
I want you to read chapter 30.
我们请看三十章。
Chapter 30, we read verse 8.
三十章第八节。
The same word is mentioned here.
这个同样的，单词也用。用在这里。
There were sons of fools, yes, sons of wild men. They were scourged from the land.
这些都是愚妄下贱人的儿女，他们被鞭打赶出境。愚妄下贱人。
下贱哦 ，vile men is just like men, you know, who has no respect at all.
这个意思就是说，一个人就是完全没有受到人尊重的意思。
That's why Job said about himself.
这个是约伯对自己的解释。
That he is a wild person.
他说自己是个卑贱的人。
Because he has sinned with his mouth.
因为他以他的口犯罪得罪神。
Now I want you to read chapter 42.
我们再看四十二章。
We read chapter 42.
我们请看四十二章。
Chapter 42.
四十二章。
We read from verse 3.
我们请看第三节。
You ask who is this who hides counsel without knowledge? Therefore, I have uttered what I did not understand, things too wonderful for me which I did not know.
第三节，谁用无知的言语使你的旨意隐藏呢？我所说的。这些事太奇妙，是我不知道的。
Verse 6.
第六节。
Therefore I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes.
因此我厌恶自己，在尘土和灰尘中懊悔。
So he repented before the Lord.
所以约伯在神的面前来懊悔忏悔。
We said he was a righteous person.
我们知道之前说他是一个公正直的人。
Yes, he was made righteous by God.
是的，他之前是被神认为是个正直公义的人。
When he was put to the test.
但是当他被放到试验当中
，Initially he was able to withstand all the tests.
一开始他是有办法来抵挡这些试验。
But when his friend came,
但是当他的朋友来之后
，We find that in a way he has lost control of himself.
我们会发现在这过程当中，他好像就是自己失去了这个指控的能
力。But the good things about Job is that he was willing to repent.
但是约伯好的一点是他可以愿意来悔改。
He even hated himself so much.
他甚至厌恶自己。
It's like he set himself to be like a vile person.
就像他对自己说自己是个卑贱的人一样。
And because of that, God restored him.
因为这样子，所以神来原谅他，重新复兴他。
So from all these verses, what can we learn?
所以从这几节当中，我们可以学习到什么呢？
You find that in our lives, sometimes we do make mistakes, especially in times of trouble.
我们都知道，在我们的生命当中，特别是在受困难的时候呢，我们都会来做错事情。
When we are being, spoken against, then obviously we'll make mistakes in our words.
就是当我们就是认为很，就是我们经常会在别人敌对我们的时候呢，都会在言语上都会出错。
You find that when the friend came, they were not talking to him with words of comfort.
我们会发现约伯的朋友来的时候呢，他们所讲的话都不是安慰的话语。
You find that their words are attacking words.
我们会发现他朋友所讲的话都是带有攻击性的。
Just give you one or two examples.
我们可以看一两个例子。
We turn to chapter 5.
请看约伯记五章。
Job chapter 5.
约伯记五章。
We read verse 3.
第三节。
Job chapter 5, verse 3.
约伯记第五章第三节。
These are the words spoken by one of his friends called Eliphaz.
这个是约伯的其中一个朋友以利法所说的话。
Now I have seen the foolish taking root, But suddenly I curse his dwelling place. Verse 4, his sons are far from safety. They are crushed in the gate, and there is no deliverer.
三节，我曾见一万人扎下根，但我忽然咒诅他的住处，他的儿女远离稳妥的地步，在城口中被压，并无人搭救。
We know that Job's children die in an accident.
我们知道约伯的儿女在一场意外中过世了。
So this friend came to him and spoke words of attack.
所以他的朋友来到这里，对约伯所说的话都是带有攻击性的。
Now we read chapter 8.
我们请看第八章。
Job chapter 8.
约伯记第八章。
And here is another friend of his called Bildad.
这里是他另外一个朋友叫比勒达。
He persuaded Job to repent.
他来说服劝服约伯要悔改。
Now read verse 4.
第四节。
If your sons have sinned against him, he has cast them away for their transgression.
或者你的儿女得罪了他，他使他们受报应。
It's like, you know, direct attack, yeah, on Job.
这个是对约伯很直接的攻击。
We need to understand that he was in bereavement.
我们知道就是约伯是已经是在一个非常的哀伤的时候。
And he also suffering from this, you know, boils all over the body.
就是他全身都长满了毒疮。
And when they came to him.
但是这些人来到他面前。
So what did they say to him?
他们对约伯说了什么呢？
So your son have sinned against, if your son have sinned against him,He has cast them away for their transgressions.
或者是因为你的儿女得罪了神，是他使他们受到报应。
So you find that all these words, yeah, you know, actually are very hard to accept.
我们会发现他朋友所说的这些话其实是很难接受的。
But finally, you know, Job listened, yeah, to the word of God.
最终约伯就开始听神的话。
So follow the instruction of the Lord.
并且来跟随神的指示。
And repented before God.
并且在神的面前悔改。
You find that his repentance is genuine.
我们会发现约伯的这个悔改是非常的无伪的。
How do we know that he was genuine?
我们如何知道约伯的悔改是很真实的呢？
We turn back to Job.
我们请看回约伯记。
We read chapter 42.
42章。
Chapter 42.
约伯记42章。
We read verse 8.
第八节。
Now therefore take for yourself seven bulls and seven rams, go to my servant Job, and offer up for yourself a burnt offering. My servant Job shall pray for you, for I will accept him, lest I deal with you according to your folly, because you have not spoken of me what is right, as my servant Job has.
现在你们要去取七只公羊，七只公牛，七只公羊，到我仆人约伯那里去，为自己献上燔祭。我的仆人约伯却为你们祈祷，我因悦纳他，却不按你们的余望辩你们。你们议论我，不如我的仆人约伯说的是。
God wanted Job to intercede for his three friends.
神要约伯来为他的三个朋友来代求。
Now remember the words that they have spoken against Job.
就我们记住，记到之前三个朋友对约伯所说攻击的话语。
You'll find that Job was able to accept the command from the Lord.
但是我们会发现约伯是可以来接受神给他的这个命令。
That's why we say his repentance is genuine.
所以这就是为什么我们说约伯的悔改是很真实的。
And his repentance is backed up with actions.
因为他的这个悔改是有着他的这个行为来
做出来。So when we talk about true repentance in the church,
所以当我们讲到教会里真正的悔改
or our repentance before God,
或者是我们在神面前的悔改
it has to be genuine.
一定要是真正的。
And we have to back it up with good actions.
我们要用行动来说明我们真正的悔改。
We have to back it up by following the instructions of the Lord.
我们也要来以跟随并且顺服于神的指示来。
That's why the Bible says he is a righteous man.
这就是为什么圣经上面说约伯是个公义的人。
In time of great trial, he was willing to pray for his friends.
因为在试炼的时候呢，他还是很愿意为自己的朋友代求。
I guess this is something that we need to learn as well.
所以我想这也是我们每一位都要学习的。
And we also can see that he was able to persevere throughout.
并且我们也可以看出约伯是可以忍耐。
Yes, he became angry.
是的，约伯在某一刻就很生气。
He has spoken some loose words.
他可能是讲出失去失去意志的话语。
And we also realize that at time he may not be able to control himself.
我们也会知道在某一刻他没有办法控制自己。
The bottom line is that he had not deserted God.
但是这个底线是他没有来弃绝神。
That's why we find that he persevered to the end.
所以我们可以看到约伯是忍耐到底。
So before we conclude, we are going to look at a few verses.
在我们结束之前我们再来看几节。
We turn to the book of Psalms.
请看诗篇。
Turn to the book of Psalms, chapter 18.
诗篇十八篇。
We read verse 30.
三十节。
Chapter 18, verse 30.
十八篇三十节。
Now, verse 30. As for God, His way is perfect. The word of the Lord is proven. He is a shield to all who trust in Him.
至于神，他的道是完全的，神的话是炼净的。凡投靠他的，他便做他们的盾牌。
As far as the case of Job is concerned, how is God's way perfect?
那我们看到约伯的这个例子的话呢，我们是如何知道神的道是完全的呢？
Because finally, Job came to realize.
因为最终约伯了解到，
God could do anything he desires.
神可以做他自己所任意要做的一件事情。
No one can stop him from doing anything.
没有人可以阻止神做任何的事情。
So on the part of man is we have to submit.
所以对人的人的人的这部分来说呢，我们一定要来顺服于神。
So Job has seen the perfect way of God.
所以约伯亲眼看见神的道是完全的。
That is the compassion of God towards Job.
这个就是神对约伯的这个怜悯。
And that is also God's mercy.
这也是神的这个大慈悲。
We turn to Psalms chapter 34.
我们再看回诗篇三十四篇。
Psalms chapter 34.
诗篇三十四篇。
We read verse 19.
十九节。
Psalm chapter 34, we read verse 19.
诗篇三十诗篇十九节。
Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all.
一人多有苦难，但神救他脱离这一切。
So in the case of Job,
在约伯的这个事情当中，
afflictions came from Satan.
他的这些苦难都是从撒旦来的。
Because he maintained his integrity before God.
因为他持守在对神的这个纯正。
Truly, God has delivered him of.Out of all the tribulations,
我们可以看到神是真正的救他脱离一切患难。
Not only that, God actually gave him back what he has lost, twice as much.
不单单是这样子，神最终祝福约伯，就是他之前先有的，神就是大双倍的来祝福他。
This is the compassion and the mercy of God.
这个就是神的怜悯和慈悲。
Finally, we read Job chapter 19.
我们最后再看约伯记十九章。
Job chapter 19.
约伯记十九章
We read verse 25.
二十五节
These are the words spoken by Job. He showed great trust in his Lord, the one who saved him.
这个就是约伯所说的话，就是展现出他对神的这种信心。
For I know that my Redeemer lives, and he shall stand at last on the earth.
我知道我的救赎主活着，末了必站立在地上。
He knows the Redeemer lives.
约伯知道他的救赎主活着。
Today we also know that our Lord Jesus lives.
今天我们也知道我们的主耶稣也是活着。
Because he lives, therefore we shall also live.
因为主耶稣活着，所以我们也要活着。
This is our faith in Jesus Christ.
这个是我们对主耶稣基督的信心。
We believe that as long as we keep our faith to the end,
我们相信只要我们来把我们的信心持守到底的话，
then we shall live with our Lord forever and ever.
那么我们就会与我们的主一同永远的活着。
May the Lord help us.
愿神帮助我们。
Because of time factor, we are not going to sing him.
因为时间的原因，我们就不唱诗了。
Because now is the prayer, especially for the RE students.
今天我们有特别为是宗教教育学生的祷告。
So we ask all the RE students to come to the front to pray.
所以我们要要求所有的宗教学生都到前面来祷告。
So we ask all the deacons who are present here to help laying hands on them.
我们也希望在这里的执事都可以为他们来按手。
So when you kneel, please kneel properly in rows.
所以当你们在跪在前面祷告的时候呢，请你们就是跪的按一排一排的顺序来祷告。